Hello and welcome. My name is Asil Al-Bassam. I'm a research specialist at GPCA and the chair of the upcoming GPCA Youth Committee. Welcome to the 15th GPCA Annual Forum. With me today is a very special guest, Mr. Ashraf Al-Ma'mari, Chief of People, Technology and Culture at OQ. Mr. Ashraf, thank you for taking the time to join us today and welcome.
Most welcome and pleasure is mine.
Thank you so much. We'll dive into the questions if you'll allow me to do so. Obviously, you gave a very wonderful keynote presentation at the Leaders of Tomorrow seminar earlier this morning. You gave great career advice to the students on career development and building a roadmap for the future. And not to discount also the great case study that you've mentioned on the Liwa Plastics Industry Complex. Now to my question. What, in your view, is the importance of initiatives such as the Leaders of Tomorrow to help nurture and develop the local human capital in the Arabian Gulf?
Sure, and my personal view is very, very important. As we all know, if we also have a look at the demographics of the GCC countries, in which it says very much visible in the pyramid, our youngsters are the majority of population in our countries. And they are the majority in time of facing many challenges in the external environment. Industries are shifting and there are, you know, crises globally that also impacting us. So to me, all GCC countries made it very much clear the investment in the human capital is the factor of success for tomorrow. And hence such initiatives, great initiatives for investing in the young professionals in the petrochemical industries.
That's amazing, actually. Shedding light on that, I believe capability building and making sure that a platform is created to basically connect the youth to people who are already in the industry is very important to ensure that their career developments are secured for the future. Thank you for that. Now we want to jump into the next question. This is a little different from the first one. In your view, how did the COVID-19 pandemic transform OQ's people's strategy and vision?
Yeah, so the pandemic, first of all, transformed many mindsets for all of us as individuals. And to me, there were many assumptions that we had for very much long time that has been tested and proved wrong in the pandemic era. The concept of remote working is one of these assumptions. And to me, OQ, as many other, you know, big organizations, has been in review in terms of the impacts of this global crisis. So our vision remains that we are investing in the, you know, energy for the country, Oman. We are a state-owned enterprise. What we have been going through in terms of revision is how can we also, in reflection of these impacts, made our investments wiser and in a mode of very much selective growth. We had a lot of priorities that we are focusing in, and which we are focusing in the cost management. We are a relatively big organization within the country, so the whole concept of being effective and efficient is very, very much important. We are reviewing our processes towards more productive and more lean organization. On top of that, we are investing in the future. So one of our main investment pillars is the investment on the alternative energy. And we have achieved critical milestones in 2021, which we trust will enable us to be a key player in the country in that arena.
Thank you, Mr. Ashraf. I think you've highlighted some important points. And now maybe this question can be subsequent to the first question, in which I would like to understand from you, how do you approach talent development and fostering the young generation of the country at OQ? Can you tell us more about the programs and initiatives related to this within the organization?
Sure, it's a journey, and we have started since we integrated 2 years back. And the first step is to understand what type of capabilities we have. So it all started with an effort of data management, so we understand the level of capabilities we have inside the organization, the different disciplines of people, and the different layers of the organization. Accordingly, we have designed some initiatives to strengthen our areas, especially in the technical side. So there are special programs for the young professionals who are graduates of technical diploma, and they go through 2 years development program in which professional certification is provided. and they are also rotated to different disciplines, and then they can become individual contributors within the organization. There are also programs for the bachelor degree, either engineers or any other corporate field. They go through a design program that includes job rotations, mentorship program, and professional certification. In the other layers within the organization, we do focus on leadership. So there are leadership initiatives and leadership programs that we apply, and we align it with our succession management. All in all, we try our best to build our capabilities, and that people within the organization, they should feel that they are taken care of by the organization. So we retain them, and you know, we have them ready for the growth mandates that we aspire as OQ.
Thank you, Mr. Ashraf. I believe you've highlighted very important points, especially taking care of the people within your organization to make sure they feel important, they feel valued, and they feel included, which also leads me to the next question. I believe this is a very important topic across across the world now, diversity and inclusion. It's become an important driver for companies in general, and this includes the petrochemical companies, specifically in the GCC now. Do you have any specific policies or programs in place to advance diversity and inclusion at OQ? And how do you prioritize to align with the wider ESG agendas that are already in place?
So it's work in progress. Overall, we have around 40 plus nationalities working under the umbrella of OQ and its subsidiaries. In terms of the ratio male versus female, we have around 11% of female population within the organization. And I said work in progress because we give it special attention after our integration program. There are policies that we are currently developing, and of course to enable especially the female in the petrochemical industries being able to be inside our petrochemical and refinery plants. There are some facility setups and policies that we are improving to enable them to be productive and be working in a comfortable working environment.
That's great to hear. I believe this topic is very important, especially if we want to further advance within the industry and make sure that everyone is to basically help increase the industry attractiveness and build a positive image for the industry as well. Mr. Ashraf, this leads me to my last question. The pandemic has accelerated trends such as remote working, as we all know, digitalization as well, and the future of work. How do you expect these trends to evolve into the future, and what would their impact be on the petrochemical industry, specifically in the region?
So in terms of remote working, for example, I think many organizations took that as an exceptional decision to allow people to work from anywhere, apart from the workplace itself. And now that is becoming a trend. It's a policy that will enable employees, no matter of the pandemic situation, to be productive from any place they feel they can be productive in. We have already developed our guidelines in that sense, and very soon we will announce it within OQ. I have seen other organizations that already announced it as well, inside Oman and outside as well. In terms of the digitization transformation, we have a special function for our digitalization transformation. There has been initiatives that has been already implemented, and mainly focusing on our downstream business line and production line, including integrated data management system in which we observe and monitor our refineries production mix, and then we align it with our market demand. And of course, applications such as digital turnaround, etc. So that is also a priority for the organization, because it will enable us to cope with the changes and also enable the organization to be more agile and more effective and productive.
Thank you, Mr. Ashraf. I believe these are very important points that you've highlighted here today. Before we end our discussion, I just wanted to know if you have any advice you'd like to give to the younger generation in specific, as they approach their career progression in the industry. Any advice you'd like to give to them or to the wider audience in general?
Sure. So to them, they are the future of the industry. There are a lot of hopes and demands and aspirations by different employers, and they are encouraged to join the petrochemical industry, and that's why the GPCA is taking a special effort for a dedicated workshops and sessions for the leaders of tomorrow. And to me, it's very much interesting field, because there is a very much big room of innovation in the petrochemical industry, the whole transformations that we have seen and that we are aspiring to see, also shifting to the alternative energy, will depend on them joining us and joining, you know, hands in hands with the current expertise in the industry to make tomorrow better. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Ashraf. Thank you for taking the time to join us today. All the best. Until next time, thank you, everyone.